budgets.
Sir, I passionately heard the speeches and arguments which have been advanced by the honorable member during his debate by honorable member Jagadambal Pal. Sir, I recall the famous quotes from Karl Marx when he wrote his contemporary Feuerbach. He said, the philosophers of this world interpreted the world many ways, but the thing is how to change it. Much has been spoken on the abrogation of Article 370 and the repeal of 35A in the Constitution. It's a mere repetition. But the thing is, having made the amendments, having brought the abrogation, what has been done for past 7 months? That is very important. Rewriting history again and again, accusing the ball on Jawaharlal Nehru or Gandhi or anybody else for bringing 370 will not be no use. You introduced the abrogation, accordingly it was done. 7 months has been passed away. Now you have to tell, see the tangible results. We did a correct thing. Everything is happening. Our promises are being brought into actions. That is not your speech. Of course, you mentioned what are all the allocation that has been made in the budget. Nothing else. Sir, with pain, yes, I will come to you. Sir, the budget of the Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh is being discussed in the RS House. Not in a normal situation. After deploying 45,000 troops in the valley, and the leaders of the main political stream have been arrested. And I can say that even the Act of Prevention of Security Act that has been imposed, the draconian law, very old law that was imposed as against the political leaders, we are discussing budget in this house. That itself shows the Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh have not been put into normalcy. Sir, when resolution was passed in the house to abrogate Article 370, the fears and apprehensions raised by the opposition are still pending, which was not at all addressed and which was not at all neither removed. Sir, after 7 months, this house again has the opportunity to revisit the Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh with the different footings. Sir, we are all aware that the State Assembly does not have the opportunity to discuss the will of their people, will of its people, and it is an indirect way that this Parliament is discussing the budget of the Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, so that I can say with due respect to the treasury benches that this budget discussion is completely ceremonial and it is not in true spirit. It can't be true spirit because we are not Kashmiris. Sir, however, I hope while preparing the budget, the government must have in its mind to address the need and will of the present context of the people in the prevailing situation of economical and political situation in Jammu and Kashmir. Sir, I do not want to go to the detail of the budget in microwave way, quoting the numerical strength and numerical figures in the budget available. But I can say with sincerity that the attempt that has been made to satisfy the outer world, international community, as if we allocated a substantial amount of budgetary support for the well-being of the people, which is not at all true, I will demonstrate here. Sir, a state cannot be a prosperous and peace unless and until the social harmony is maintained within the territory of the state or within the territory of the country. So what is the situation today in the Kashmir? Sir, the foremost question which arises in mind is whether this budgetary support, if at all, with a positive sense, with affirmative nature, a substantial amount that has been allotted during the budget, if at all, whether the people of Jammu Kashmir are in a proper position to receive it in a proper way and to have avail it. I do not think so. Sir, what was the Solomon promise which was given by the Home Minister? I can quote, he used the very systematic word, implemented constitutional transformation. The implemented constitutional transformation, that is abrogation of Article 370 and 35A, promise that was given by the Home Minister here on the floor of the House, that It was done to pay the way for the better administration, good governance, and economical development. And further, he states that Article 370 was the root cause for corruption and militancy in Jammu Kashmir. Sir, let us veil. The assurance that was given by the Home Minister is not fully fulfilled. It can't be. Let him take his own time. But sincere attempt, whether it was taken to consideration, is there any sincere attempt that has been made on this regard? Sir, when the assurances were given by the HM for the better administration and the good governance and economic development, what was the status of the Jammu and Kashmir? When the assurance was given by the HM, the state has already proved in terms of gender indicators, MMR, maternal mortality rate, infant mortality rate, IMR, age of marriage, sex ratio, female literacy are better than the Indian average. Not only more than Indian average, which is much more better than the Bhimrao states. So what type of changes you wanted to give it? You want to picturize the Jammu Kashmir is dwindled down because of 370 and we are going to make a very big revolution. Is it not contrary to the document? So this is available. Sir, let us take the budget now. A deliberate attempt that has been made to picturize that the borrowing on capital expenditure is reduced and the revenue surplus is increased. Good. I don't want to go into the figures, but have a look out of the graphics. Just I wanted to show some their graph that has been cited in the book. Sir, administrative sector, total capital budget, 2,074 crores. Out of this, how much hope? 53.57%. Administrative sector, major portion that has been allocated to the Home Department. For what purpose? To maintain the state police, to maintain the security forces. What does it mean? Does it mean to say the Kashmir, the state of Kashmir and Ladakh have been removed from the dangerous zone or in insecure manner? That is not at all there. Sir, coming to the next one, I can say one or two figures. Social sector, 4,969 crore. How much there? Health, that has 25.52. Then the labor and employment stationary budget, again it is 20%. Then the tribal affairs. Sir, Ladakh, everybody knows there is a substantial amount of population in the tribal in the Ladakh. But how much it is? Only, I think, 5.9%. It's a mini school. Sir, coming to the overall performance in terms of GDP, sectoral investment contribution to the GDP, how much? Social sector, 12%. Economic sector, 29%. Administrative sector, 5.35%. On the other hand, infrastructure sector, 52%. I am not able to understand what is 52% of infrastructure in Jammu and Kashmir. Does it mean to say you are assured before the house, once the 370 is abrogated, the foreign investors will come to the state and the huge investment will be made? But no attempt was made. Here's the evidence to say that people are interested. After the 370 was abrogated, that people are interested to invest in the states. Sir, huge amount that has been allocated for the disaster. What is this disaster in the states? You want to say it is for rehabilitation. Disaster and rehabilitation, when it will come? There is no natural calamity. There is no tsunami. There is no big, untoward incident took place in the state because of the natural calamity. Why this much of amount is being done? The reason is, you need more money because people are suffering there because of this imposition of curfew, because of the imposition of your own clampdown. Because of this, you need this money. Sir, similarly I can say that, sir, after 7 or 8 months experience, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh are going to be passed to meet the further deterioration in all respects. sir, what is happening today? What is happening today? Core sectors of the economy witnessed a steep decline after the abrogation of 370. Economy of Kashmir lost 178 billion Indian rupees. More than 90,000 jobs in the sector of handlooms, tourism and IT are lost. First time after 70 years, there is a heavy slowdown in the economy. For example, take Apple industry. A worth of 80 billion Indian rupee, which constituted 8% of GDP of the state, is mostly affected. Who is responsible for this? Does it mean to say 370 has gone away and everything is normal in the state? Not at all. Sir, threats of militants coupled with the government's severe clampdown not only delayed the harvest of the agriculture and apple and everything, but also it severely attacked the restoration of the civil life in the Kashmir. Sir, on the other hand, luckily, Foreign Affairs Ministry is here. What is the scenario about the Kashmir in the international arena? So how the actions of the government are being weighed by the international community? On October 29, India allowed 27 members, a delegation of 27 members of European Union delegation, on a private invitation of an NGO. Allegation was made against 27, out of the 27 members, 22 members are from right-wing Islamophobic background, and it was termed guided tour through five-star hotel in Srinagar. UK parliamentarian, Sir Mr. Chris Davis of Democratic Party, claimed that the invitation by the government of India was revoked for him after he insisted that he expects a free exchange of interaction with the public in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. Is it not same on our part? Sir, you are saying that the international community is visiting, but our own leaders are not at all allowed to go to Kashmir. What does it mean? What type of democracy we are maintaining here? Sir, on October 22, US Congressional panel described the entire situation a lockdown and humanitarian crisis. Sir, with painful heart, I can quote, six American lawmakers further raised human rights concerns in a letter to the Indian ambassador, U.S. United States Ambassador Harishwardhan Srinna. External Affairs Ministry is here. A letter was handed over to the Indian High Commission to the U.S., where it was stated, I quote, "We believe true transparency can only be achieved when journalists and members of the Congress are allowed to free access to the region of Kashmir. We encourage India to open Jammu Kashmir to both domestic and foreign journalists and other international visitors in the interest of the open media and increase in communication," unquote, which was not done by you. Sir, what is needed today? Not budgetary support, I am telling. Not substantial amount of money. It is essential for the state through the ceremonial activities of this budget. But what is essentially needed? Essentially needed is trust. Please rebuild the trust deficit and win over the confidence of the people in Jammu and Kashmir. Absolutely. Please repeal Prevent Protection of Security Act, hijacked political process. Sir, hijacked political process, I am going to complete. Hijacked political process and the detained political leaders must be freed. In the absence of the measures, the budget will fed up with all your mumbo jumbo and abracadabra. Thank you, sir.
Very good.